Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making eggnog. This is another seasonal treat, and some of you have been requesting eggnog. So I'm going to make a variety of eggnog that is non-alcoholic, but I'm also going to leave you the option of adding some alcohol to it if you would like. So here's the way we make eggnog. We start with eggs. So I have 3 eggs that I've already beaten. I use my mixer and I beat these thoroughly so that they'd be nice and fluffy. To that, I'm going to add some sweetened condensed milk, and I chose the fat-free variety of sweetened condensed milk. This is a 14-ounce container, but I only need half of it. So I'm going to just pour this out and then check. It's pretty much full to the top, so I want it to be half full. This doesn't have to be exact. If that looks pretty good to me. And next is vanilla extract. So I have 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla extract to go into the mixture. And then we have milk. I use skim milk, and if you want to use whole milk, that's fine, but it's not gonna make that much difference. 2 cups. And then a little bit of salt for seasoning here. Just a little bit. Just sprinkle it in and use your own judgment. And then I need my spoon here. So we'll let it bring in a little bit more of that sweetened condensed milk. And I just stir this around. And I'm not quite finished, but you do need to blend this thoroughly so that the foamy egg whites get incorporated into the milk and sweetened condensed milk mixture. So just stir that around a little bit. And I have some whipping cream over here that I have been leaving in this carton, because once you pour it out into a container like this, it starts to warm up. It doesn't meet very well if it's warm. So you want cold whipping cream. And it doesn't take very much for this amount. I'm just really making a half a recipe. So if you want a large recipe, then double everything. I'm going to use 1/4 cup. I know that sounds like a very small amount, but it would be more than that if I were making a full recipe. So I'm just going to get this up to 2 ounces. And it's cold, so I will be able to beat it with an electric mixer. So I'm coming over here, pouring that in. This is going to be noisy, so I'll go away and do the beating and then come back and finish up our eggnog. You want to beat your whipping cream just until it forms soft peaks, like this. And once you have those soft peaks, there's not a lot of whipping cream here, but immediately go ahead and add that to your mixture. And just fold it in. You can see what it looks like. And then just fold. I wouldn't use a mixer to mix this. You just want to kind of swirl that around until it gets blended in and becomes part of the entire mixture. And as far as the non-alcoholic variety is concerned, this is pretty much it. Now, I wouldn't serve it in a bowl like this, and it's actually a little lost in my punch bowl, but it will give you the idea of the presence that I would like to have for this particular dish. There's the eggnog poured out in a punch bowl. Imagine it being about twice that much for the full recipe. And then over the top, what you're going to do is sprinkle a little ground nutmeg. So we just give this a little flair. That's generally expected. That's the look that eggnog has. And then it's into the refrigerator and to be served chilled. Now, I want to let you see what it looks like when it's served, so I'm going to dip some out in a little glass. This is actually an antique juice glass, but I think it's really nice for something like eggnog. So I would just dip it out with a ladle and into the glass. And I kind of went down the sides a little bit on that one. Sorry about that. and I'll just put that one down. And then for my second one, I'm gonna make it with a little alcohol. So I'll be a little more careful in putting this in. Still wants to come down the side. So you'll need to keep a cloth or paper towel handy so that you can take care of that. I didn't fill this one all the way to the top because I plan to put a little alcohol in. Excuse me just a moment. I've chosen rum, and this is a golden rum, and I've already poured out a small amount. I think you can only use a small amount in a small glass like this, so maybe 1/2 ounce. It's just to your taste, but you can pour that in. You can pour as much of that or as little of that as you like, and then blend it around with a little spoon, and then you have your individual serving, which is alcoholic eggnog with rum. So we have our choice here of the non-alcoholic eggnog or the alcoholic eggnog. There you go.